All right. Now, according to our Sabbath school schedule, the first thing we want to do is talk about the impossible. And the reason I've chosen this particular little science demonstration is because Moses was leading the children of Israel, and they came up to the Red Sea, and Pharaoh and his army was behind them, and it seemed like an impossible situation. And each one of us has impossibilities that we face day by day, but God is able to deliver us from all impossibilities, just like Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego in the fiery furnace, or before they were cast in, they said, "Our God is able to deliver us, but if he chooses not to, we will still serve him." And that's the attitude we all need to have. God is able to deliver us, but if he chooses not, he has a greater purpose and plan in mind. So let's open up our slideshow entitled Doing the Impossible. And I have to find it right there. Is 22% a good percent to use for this? All right, but before we talk about this simple little demonstration, and I'd like to welcome, are we starting now?
We've already started.
Okay, I'd like to welcome all those who are listening by video also to this little science demonstration entitled Doing the Impossible. And before we talk about something that might seem impossible, I'd like us to think about someone who lived about 100 or so years ago, and I promised you a story a Sabbath or two back about Michael Faraday, and I want to tell you just a little bit about Michael Faraday, because it seemed like he did the impossible too. Do you know that he was born into a family that was challenged financially? They lived in just a little place in England with not very many luxuries in this life. And he was able to go to school, but just for a few years, to learn the basics of reading, writing, and arithmetic. And that's it. And if you ever happen to read any of his letters or any of his notes as an adult, you'll notice that he failed to remember, or maybe never learned, that every sentence begins with something. What is that, Ashley?
Capital.
A capital. I'm sure Benjamin knows that too. Michael Faraday, the genius that he was, had a very hard time with some of these things. I'm going to do the impossible and condense what I've said in the last 5 minutes into this little bit that our science demonstration is about doing the impossible. And it connects with Moses, who led the Israelites out of Egypt, and they came up to the Red Sea, and an impossibility seemed to face everyone. Of course, Moses wasn't fooled. But and Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego, even though they were about to be cast into the burning fiery furnace, which seemed like an impossibility, they told Nebuchadnezzar that our God is able to deliver us, but if he should not, we will still serve him because he is worthy. And that's what we need to keep in our minds as we serve God day by day. And I wanted to just bring in Michael Faraday a little bit, because he was a person born into a very poor family in England. And he had only the rudiments of education. A few years at his school is all his parents could afford, and he learned to read and to write and to do arithmetic. Only addition and subtraction, that's as far as it went for Michael Faraday. But he became one of the great scientists of our time. Einstein kept a picture of him in his office in different places where he was, because Einstein realized the greatness that Michael Faraday accomplished for us in the scientific world. And just to give you a few things about Michael Faraday, he's contributed to the fields of electromagnetism and electrochemistry, and things have been named after him. For example, there's the Faraday effect, the Faraday cage, the Faraday constant, the Faraday cup, the Faraday laws of electrolysis, and it goes on. And it's not because he had great education, it's because he was blessed of God and applied himself to learning and to understanding things. And his family attended a little humble church in the slum area of England, and Michael Faraday continued to go there, even though he grew up and he became famous for the things he was understanding and discovering and giving to the rest of the world. He continued, of course, this was on Sunday, but on Sundays to go to this humble gathering of people who also probably couldn't read or write or do arithmetic very well, but they had God's Spirit there. And Michael Faraday did not walk away from that, but he maintained his relationship with his Heavenly Father, as well as learning and loving science and being blessed of God to learn things. Now, on our science demonstration, I'm opening up to slide 2. It's based on Mark 10:27. And Jesus, looking upon them, saith, with men it is impossible, but not with God. For with God, Ashley, you need to be over here so they can hear you, but all things are possible. Next slide. The only materials you need for this demonstration are 2 plungers. Plungers that you might find in a bathroom. Something like this. So we have a matched pair. You just need 2 plungers like that. And we're going to put them together and see how possible it is to pull them apart. But I want to tell you, first of all, inside this area, this bell of the plunger, the only thing there is what?
Air.
Air. That's right. And so, when we put 2 plungers together and squeeze them together, we are pushing out the air and making a suction, so to speak. And maybe you could do that here. Can you pull the table up? It's impossible, isn't it? No, don't. You can't break the seal, my dear. That wouldn't be fair. Okay, but as you can see, even plunging on a table. Now, if our table were small enough, it could probably lift that table. However, if we poked a little hole, just a little hole, a pinhole almost, into the rubber of this, do you think it would work then?
No.
Why not?
Because the air would be able to
have a way. So when you press down on it, even though the air would come out that
hole.
No, I hope there's not a hole. No. Oh, dear, I don't even... Pastor, would you like to see if you're strong enough to pull this up? Not me. Oh, he's taking the challenge. Okay. Maybe you can lift the tables for us. Okay, thank you. All right, that's on the table. Now we want to put these plungers together. And then Ash and I are going to try to do the impossible and pull them apart. And the only fair way to do that is to pull straight out on the handles, because of course we know if we tilt the handle and pull, that will break the seal and allow air back in there. Do we have it together? All right. Now, Ashley, wait a minute. You can't pull so far that you'll land on your bottom. I don't want you to fall down.
And hold it level.
And you have to hold it level, and we're going to see if we can pull this apart. Ashley, go ahead.
You're supposed to pull it too.
Okay, it worked. Let's try it one more time. Can you put them back together? Because while she's putting them back together, it's a little tough. I want to tell you, if we move on to slide 9. In 1654, in Magdeburg, Germany, a scientist brought 16 horses and 2 large copper bulls before the emperor. The metal bulls, each about 2 feet in diameter, so 2 feet, that's, you know, not that huge, were placed snugly together with a leather fitting between them. The inside air was then removed with a pump. I don't know how he did it, but that's what he did. He got the air out, in other words, made a vacuum in those attached bulls. And then 8 horses were harnessed on one side and 8 horses harnessed on the other side to pull them apart. It was a hard job for these 16 horses, and they finally succeeded, but it was difficult. Next slide. This dramatic demonstration showed to the emperor the surprising effect of air pressure. with no air inside, and here in our plungers, with no air inside, then the air outside is pressing against this so much that the weight of the pressure is so heavy that it's hard for us to overcome it. Let's try one more time. Now, I don't want you to fall, Ashley. There, it's coming. Okay, thank you very much, Ashley. And that's the end of our little demonstration. But I want to back up and explain to you why this happens. Let's back up to slide 6. Tells us why this happens. When two plungers are pushed together, the inside air is expelled. A plunger that is 5 inches in diameter, and that's about the size of what we had, has an outside surface area of about 40 square inches. Each square inch on the outside surface experiences a force from the air about 15 pounds. Thus, the plungers are held together by an invisible force of several hundred pounds. And when Ashley and I are pulling on that, we are trying to overcome that force on the plungers. When the plungers are turned at right angles, the inside vacuum is broken as outside air is admitted. And all of us have used suction at some time in our lives. We put something up on the window, maybe to bird feeder hanging from that. And that little cup, what it does, when you press on it, you're getting all the air out, and then all the outside air is pressing on it and keeping it in place. So it seems like the impossible, but it really isn't. God is the author of all of this. And we do want to finish our little science demonstration now, thanking each one of you for listening to us. And come back next Sabbath, because if all goes well, we will have a little demonstration about radio waves. If all goes well, because we don't always get good radio signal up here where we're at in this little valley in West Virginia. But until then, may God richly bless you. Goodbye for now.